लड़ाई में अब आप रहिए दो कदम आगे विद फिलिप्स एयर फ्रायर. इसकी ट्विन टर्बोस्टार टेक्नोलॉजी कुक्स विद अप टू 90% लेस फैट. देयर्स ऑलवेज अ वे टू मेक लाइफ बेटर. इनोवेशन एंड यू फिलिप्स.
Yeah, so we're right inside Farm Lore. Just had a lovely conversation with Johnson, Maitri and Avinash, the three key members behind Farm Lore. And it's lovely to know these Indian chefs who are pushing the envelope. The beauty about this place, it's sustainable cooking. The concept is sustainable cooking. Funnily, Friday, I wore a red t-shirt in the morning and what happened was I was having my favorite, you know, tatte idli, you know. For those who are from Bangalore, you know what tatte idli is. And there's a massive, normally, you know, I'm quite clumsy that way. Chutney fell on it and I had to change it. I thought, okay, red, love and all that stuff. Today's actually the sustainable day for World on a Plate, life, and because we are at a sustainable place, and we have Simon Tui who runs something, a network called the Sustainable Network. Yeah, so Simon Tui, I'm really excited about sustainable farming, sustainable food, sustainable networks, media, because at the end of the day, India, like I said in my first episode, is 102 on the hunger index. And the way we can actually narrow the gap and get better at, reducing the numbers on going down on the number index is to make sure that we are not wasting in food. And sustainable farming and restaurants are all about this, right? So I'm excited about today, because we are in a farm and it's sustainable, it is a sustainable day. So like I just picked up, the chef Johnson showed me that they're actually making a raw jackfruit biryani this weekend for one of their pop-ups. And I'm going to be busy, but I'm sure I'm going to come and eat it someday. I think jackfruit is the flavor of the season. I just had a pulled jackfruit tacos and now I'm hearing about the biryani. Going ahead, 2017, where I finished. Let me tell you something. Let me complete that story, because I'm sure you guys are waiting for that story. My team is such a strong team that they miss flights altogether, Like I was telling you, they missed this flight and it was a disaster because they missed the flight. My production got delayed in Mumbai. These guys missed one of Janice Wong's suitcases, her tools and where she does her chocolatiering and painting chocolates and stuff like that at the hotel. So there had to be two people. There were 12 people on the crew. They're so strong, bonded together, that all 10 of them waited at the airport for two of them to bring the suitcase, and every one of them missed the flight. It was quite a a laugh at the end of the day, but it really put so much pressure on us. That was such small little things which create failures. So guys, make sure that you have a very strong team with a little bit of brains. Are very, very important that you need to use it at the right time. So going on, Sustainable Day, Nishant Chobe is the next chef on our masterclass. He's one of the most decorated chefs. He's won many accolades, many awards, and he's, I think, doing something. Again, he's also, he promotes a lot of sustainable cooking, and he's doing, I think, a corn cake. I'm really excited about it, and every time I see a new recipe, I'm really, really excited the kind of ingredients, the techniques Indian chefs are doing. And it is, I think, sunrise for the Indian chefs, because they've spent a lot of time in the kitchen this time because of the lockdown. We're going to see some amazing recipes coming out in 2020, and all of us are going to enjoy that. Don't forget, this at the end of today, we have Simon Tui. His DIY kits are available. Saturday, we've got Saransh Koila. His DIY kits is available. The famous Saransh Koila, who's the only Indian to be on MasterChef Australia, judge in MasterChef Australia. Of course, that is Saturday. Then Sunday, we have a massive lineup of chefs. Do not miss cooking along with these guys. So we're going to carry on Friday. It's lovely weather here, and I'm looking forward to come back and say hello to you again. See you.
Hello everyone, myself Chef Nishant Kumar Chobe, partner chef with Street Stories Bangalore, a vegetarian craft kitchen. You know what? World Hunger Warrior is actually feeding over 500,000 people over 90 days time. And World on the Plate is committed to raise funds for this noble cause. I pledge my session today to ensure that we raise funds. And there's a button in the bottom of my show where you can press and donate your fund to people who are hungry and they definitely need your support. So let's pledge that and ensure this session goes wonderful and of course the best of the charity. So let's start. My dish today is plated snack with street stories. So let's start.
Awesome.
So for this plated tea time with street stories, I have got three dishes happening on the same plate, but I'm gonna plate it. Okay, great. So first dish would be a hemp seed chutney that I'm gonna put it on a toast and you can enjoy it. The next one is a very, very fabulous seasonal nutritious jamun ki chaat. And the third thing would be kathal. Kathal is a vegetarian protein which has got amazing, nutrients and minerals. So I'm gonna put everything together and serve it to all of you. Keep seeing my session and enjoy yourself. If you have any questions, comment in the chat box and I'll ensure that my team responds to your questions as soon as possible. And also don't forget to join me just after my live video. I'm gonna come live at the Instagram, so don't forget to join me there. So to make hemp seed chutney, we need hemp seed that I have pre-soaked it in water. I'm gonna put them in this. So these are hemp seed which I have pre-soaked, and I'm gonna just garlic, wow, mint, cumin seed, roasted cumin seeds, coriander seeds, chives, not to forget chilies. Look how wonderful this is looking like. To basically ensure that the smashing becomes easy. Oh, I love this kind of flavor, aroma, because what you get out of this is beautiful. Just crush it well. So I just want to show you the texture of the chutney which has come. Look at the texture of the chutney. It's very thin, it's not very thick. But make sure you limit the consumption of this chutney, because this is a little bit, you know, the portion is well defined when you're putting it on toast. So I'm done. What I need now is I need to season it. So I'll put generous quantity of lemon and some, of course, some of salt. So I'm going to take out this fragrant hemp seed chutney in a bowl, and then I'm going to season it with lemon and salt. As I said, you should be careful in limiting your portion. I have already shared recipe. Make sure you abide by it. And this is a session for a noble cause. Please do support that. And as much as fund we have, we can feed lot many people. Thank you very much, World on the Plate, for this excellent opportunity of coming live and curate a lovely tea time snack with Street Stories. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put generous amount of lime and salt. And of course this very amazing salt I'm gonna put it. Just mix it up and let this go on the fridge before I start cooking the beautiful sauce of jamun. Wow, excellent. So I'll put it in the fridge and then come back and make that sauce for jamun. Okay, so to make the sauce, what we require is we need tamarind juice. So tamarind juice is very easy to make. What you need to do is you need to basically take dry tamarind, soak it and boil it, and then you need to ensure that it becomes nice and soft, and then you squeeze it with your hand or in a conical strainer, and then you take the juice out of it, and then this is what it is. So let me just show it to you. This is what I get when I strain it. So you need to take that. Okay, so let me switch on. Okay, so while my hemp seed chutney is resting in the fridge, time to make jamun chaat. But for that, we need sauce. This is a beautiful inspired flavored sauce. So I have taken tamarind juice, okay, which I told you before, how do you take out tamarind juice. If you don't have tamarind juice, don't worry. You can always use imli ka chutney in this. Okay, now the twist is that we need to add some bit of jaggery or palm sugar. Whatever you have, if you want, you can also add coconut sugar, you can use date sugar, okay. So I have taken palm sugar, okay. So I'm gonna add palm sugar in this, okay. Palm sugar, not too much again. Then I'm gonna add this lovely broth powder. This is a vegetarian broth powder. Then I'm gonna add this very amazing curry powder. Okay, interesting, right? Curry powder. This will give a lot of flavor to the sauce. Not to forget chili powder. No spice, no life. Okay. Some bit of vegetarian oyster sauce. If you don't have, don't worry. And then some bit of mushroom sauce. Oh God, what will you get out of it? Can you imagine that? This is a chaat. You know, chaat has got ingredients you can mix as much as you want, you know. This is a very, very nice tangy tamarind chutney inspired from Southeast Asia. Okay, that's where I'm using all those spices that you can think. Of course, not to forget a dash of soya, dark soya. Not too much, very, very little. Great. So I just repeat what all I have added. I have added red chili powder, I have added vegetarian oyster sauce, I have added mushroom sauce, I have added jaggery or palm sugar, I have added broth powder, and of course tamarind juice was the key. So I'll let it cook. What will happen? It will start thickening because of the jaggery. And the fragrance and the aroma of this chutney would be just outstanding. My jamun chaat has no yogurt, by the way. It is simple tamarind and some bit of masala. Excellent. So all this session, thankful. I'm really thankful to World on the Plate that they have given me this great opportunity to come live. The part of Street Stories, Bangalore, which is a vegetarian craft kitchen. And showcase a sustainable dish, I would say. I have used all those dishes which are very easily found in your neighborhood or in your local market. Whatever you get is very, very seasonal, so you don't need to worry, you don't require too many ingredients actually. So I can see the sauce is more or less ready. I'll just taste a bit to earn my confidence actually that yes, I have done justice to my dish. Wow, man, it's wow, monsoon out there, and then what do you need? A nice, sour, sweet, all these components of a chutney. What will happen when it is mixed with jamun? Can you imagine that? Let me just do it for you. Okay, great. So what I'm gonna do is, I'll put it on the side to cook on a very, very slow plate, and I will work on my jamun. Okay, so this is the ingredient that I was talking about. Look at this jamun, look at this. So I've taken seed out of the jamun and I have only the pulp, but to make the best use of it, I would advise that why don't you use seed also and churn it and drink, because that is very good for people who are having diabetes. So it's a healthy, nutritious session as well. Okay, so just to let you all know. Okay, so what we require for this is, this is a mortar pestle that I'm gonna use to crush some bit of tomato. So I'm gonna add tomatoes. What tomato will do is that will give sweetness. Okay, of course salt, very little salt, chili, not to forget chili. Okay, then some bit of garlic, not too much, but very, very little garlic, and then I'm gonna crush it. So you can see this is already becoming nice and saucy. And then what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna mix this in jamun. And then toss it. I also need to crush a little bit of coriander roots. That will give amazing flavor to jamun, that's why we need that. So I'm gonna crush a little bit of this coriander. I have taken coriander roots because coriander roots give better flavor than coriander leaves. That's why I'm using coriander roots. See how nice this is. This is already looking divine. Okay. In the meantime, I can see the sauce is also ready. So I'll take off the sauce from the pan and again let it cool so that it's a cold salad, so don't mix hot sauce in cold jamun. the endeavor would be incomplete and the taste would be really bad. So make sure you chill your chutney as soon as possible, and then we will start dressing it, putting some of fried onion, some amaranth, some peanut. So yeah, this is how it is. So let me just put it in the fridge, or let me just keep it open. I have to cook jackfruit, another snack, and I will plate all of this together. So I'll just take it out in a bowl, and then I'm gonna start doing my jackfruit chutney. Jackfruit taco, basically. Okay, so to make my third snack, what I need is jackfruit. Okay, so I have actually made keema of jackfruit. It's raw, by the way. Okay, and then of course I need all these ingredients. I need black mustard, cumin powder, red chili powder, coconut, grated coconut, some bit of olive, some bit of jalapenos. I have made local jalapenos. I didn't find it, so I just took some chili and put some vinegar, some ginger garlic paste, some bit of walnut, some kasuri methi. These are the basic ingredients. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a little bit of olive oil. Okay, I'll ensure that it is hot. This time I'm gonna add black mustard seeds. Let it crackle. Lovely curry leaves. As I said, this is also a healthy, nutritious session. So that's why curry leaf ensures that your blood pressure is in control. So that's why some bit of this very amazing curry patta. Okay, and then now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add some bit of ginger garlic paste. How amazing it is. So once it's cooked, more or less cooked, I'm going to add a little bit of salt. What does salt does is salt actually rapid the cooking. So if you add salt, the fragrance will also come out, and also it will ensure that your cooking is faster. Lovely. Okay, jackfruit, keema. So this is a dry preparation. I am making snack. I am making this tea time snack today. So that's why everything is little dryish, because we are really, really confused what to eat during 4 o'clock. So I thought, why don't I create a healthy tea time snack but plate it. It won't take much time to cook because it's already blended into a fine textured keema. So I have to add a little bit more olive oil. This moment I'm gonna add a little bit of red chili powder. Then cumin powder. And then this very amazing kasuri methi. Wow, look at this. Already looking like heaven. I'm so tempted to eat. Lovely. Okay, time to add some bit of olive, some chopped olive, then jalapenos, or jalapenos, or habaneros, whatever you want to call. This will ensure that this mixture become nice and sour and spicy. Wow. Last but not the least, a little bit I'm adding crunch. So I'm adding some bit of Californian walnuts. Time to taste it and see whether the genius is ready or not. Nice. It requires a little bit of seasoning, so I have to add salt. And of course, grated coconut. Look at this mixture. Because this looks outstanding, man. Wow. This is a virtual eating session. Otherwise, I would have definitely made you all try. But the flavors are just outstanding. So I taste a bit more, okay. Wow, great. Excellent. It is all the good element in this earth. It has got jackfruit for vegetarians. It's paradise, it's heaven. It is olive, it has jalapenos, it has walnut, what else you want. So I'm more or less ready with all my three dishes. So time to dress the jamun. I'll take it out from the fridge. The chutney must be cold. The keema is ready. The hemp seed chutney is ready, the toasts are ready. Wow, I'm ready for my tea time snack. What I need is a generous amount of chai. So you know, you cannot achieve a good tea time without chai. So you need to sip a little bit of tea when you are watching this session. I think that will add a lot of value to the dish, okay? So once, wow, look at this, look at the toss. Ooh la la, amazing. So I'm done. Okay, so I'll switch off and I'll take off my jamun from the fridge and then I'll start. Okay, so jamun is out of the fridge. The chutney is nice and cold. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the marinated jamun in a different bowl. Then add a little bit of fried onion. Crushed peanuts, then I'm gonna add amaranth seed ramdana, so toasted ramdana I'm adding for extra crunch, and I'm gonna add this outstanding lovely chutney, and then I'm gonna toss it. This will be a little messy, guys, but excuse me, because this is chaat. Chaat is supposed to be a little bit messy. I'll add a little bit more jamun in this. And then of course, don't forget to taste it. Wow. I need chili. Forgot. Okay. Some chili. So this is done. I'll keep it here. So this is my khari biscuit. Okay, you can take another shaped biscuit, no problem, but this is what I get. So I'm gonna put this very amazing jackfruit keema on top. Look at this, man. and then I'm gonna put it here. Okay. Actually, put it on the side. Then I am having this leaf. This is basically a Colocasia leaf. Okay, but if you want, you can also use iceberg. I did not buy an iceberg, so I'm not using it. So in that, I'm gonna put this very amazing jamun ki chaat. Okay, and then. So to make my hemp seed chutney, you don't need to just serve it like that. What I have done is I have taken yogurt, okay, and I have taken the whey out of it. You can also use cream cheese, but if you don't have this, yogurt is fine. So you put this lovely top part of the yogurt, okay, on the bread, on any toast. Guys, this is tea time, so you know. And then my very amazing this hemp seed chutney on the side. I'm gonna put it here, okay, and then I'm gonna put a little bit of coriander seed. A little bit of red chili powder, okay, a little bit of peanuts, okay, and on this also we can put some bit of coriander. So guys, this is what I was showing you today. Do look at it and keep cook with. This is what I showcased it to all of you. Very very simple and interactive session that I had. It is a really really good one. So guys, this is a session which is donated, which is actually donated to ensure that we raise funds for people who are not earning their anything, who are not at all earning anything right now. Because World on the Plate is actually doing a charity session, so do donate. There's a point where you can just tap and you can donate. So looking forward to see the best of the response, and all the best, and keep stay healthy, and of course stay nutritious. Keep eating good food, that's for sure. So this is Chef Nishant Chaubey from Street Story signing off. Tea time, Street Stories.